Hi there, and welcome back. My name is Walt Eastman, the Transportation Project Manager for Citrus County and the County Road 491 Road Widening Project. I have with me today Suniva Brown with the Building Department and Steve Davis, who is the
Florida Friendly Landscape Coordinator.
Through the Extension Office?
I work with Water Resources, but regularly, daily with Extension Services as well.
Very good. And I have them here with me today to talk about the tree restoration program out on the 491 road widening project. For those of you that remember, we took down quite a bit of trees with that project to accommodate the road widening as well as the regional drainage. Those trees that were taken down were used for lumber. They were also used for paper, as well as chipped for power consumption. So I did want to let everyone know that those trees were repurposed. With that, I'm going to turn over to Sunny to talk about the tree preservation program that the county has. That's the process we're going through for the restoration of the trees on the road project. So Sunny, could you tell us a little bit about the tree program at the county?
Sure. The tree enhancement program buys root bare saplings that are grown out by the Key Center, and the monies for those trees do come from tree removal permits. The intent of that program were to get trees back in the ground, and we have 300 trees reserved for the landscaping at the stormwater area at 491.
Very good. So it's not funded through taxpayer dollars. This is done through the permit process, through permitting fees.
Yes.
Very good. Okay. And as far as the trees themselves go for the project, we had to have a plan in place. So Sunny introduced me to Steve, and Steve, you produced the plan for the project for the landscaping. Could you explain a little bit about the plan you produced?
Yeah, one of my intent was to get some more canopy returned to the site. And do some screening, and what we did was use Florida friendly plant material, mainly Florida natives really is what we used. Those trees were used to create some vertical layering with canopy, and then some understory trees. The trees are evergreen trees, they're deciduous trees, there are flowering trees, so we should have some seasonal variety as the plants get established, grow and flourish on the site.
And with that, knowing that the trees are just at the beginning stages, we shouldn't expect it to be a full canopy immediately, so it'll take some growing time.
You know, once the trees are established and produce a root system, trees are pretty aggressive growers, these trees are. It may take a year or so for them to establish their root system, but once that happens, they're collecting all the water that falls naturally with rainfall and grow pretty quickly.
Very good. And Sunny, back to you. As part of the program that you have, you supply the funding to purchase rootstock to the, who do you partner with that?
The Key Training Center.
The Key Training Center, okay. With that, we will meet with Heidi with the Key Center, and Heidi is the Public Information Officer. And welcome back. I have with me yet Suniva Brown from the Building Department, and I have Heidi from the Key Center. Suniva, if you would mind, you have a partnership with the Key Center for the tree program. If you would mind, explain a little bit about that partnership that you have.
Sure. The monies that are paid through the tree removal permits are used to buy bare root stock that is an effort to get trees back in the ground. That bare root stock comes here to the Key Center Nursery, and the key we rely on to get these tree saplings, these bare root saplings, established and on their way.
Yes. So the clients, once they received it, they take care of the potting, they fertilize, they make sure that the plant is growing how it's supposed to. And once we have people coming in with the vouchers for to get a tree, we just give them the option and they take care of choosing whatever tree they want.
Well, Heidi, back on the County Road 491 project, do you have an idea of roughly how many trees are going to be placed on that road project? How many are going to be replanted?
300.
300 trees.
Yes.
All right, and do you know how many different species of trees?
Yes, we have about 7 species that are going to be replanted over there.
Oh, very good. And Suniva, Heidi mentioned about a voucher. What can you explain a little bit about that, how we partner with the community for this voucher?
Sure. Again, the monies from the tree removal permits is used for the Tree Enhancement Fund. So anytime someone builds a new residence in Citrus County, they get a voucher to come here to the Key and receive 2 free trees. That way, again, we're getting the trees back in the ground.
Excellent. So basically, this is like a win for the entire community where it's no cost.
Correct.
Through the permitting. The Key Center residents grow the trees out, and as part of that, they get some kind of skills?
Yes. So this was a great partnership. This is a brand new program. Well, it's been around for 10 years, but it was a brand new program for the clients at that time. And they get to learn to identify the plants, and not only identify, but care for that specific plant. Additionally, they learn how to use motorized equipment. So anywhere from a trimmer to a lawnmower, zero turn, all of that. So they learn that here in our grounds. They take care of the Key Training Center Lecanto campus's grounds and the one in Inverness. They also maintain our stores. And of course, the ones that are higher functioning that are able to use these motorized equipment, they can go out and help some people in the community as well.
Well, that's fantastic. So as you hear, it's a win for the entire community. We're restoring the 491 corridor once we're done with construction. The program is self-funded through the permit process, and we have residents here in the county who get some life skills. So it's a great win for the entire community. And that's it for this segment. I want to thank you for watching, and I would also like to thank my 3 guests today, Suniva, Heidi, and Steve. And please come back and watch for future videos.